Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Perspective. We'll be talking about the Prime Minister's address when he made some landmark announcements. He also said, a lot of things that are very important for the next few months. We, of course, as far as the caretaker setup is concerned, as far as the government completing its term and leaving on time, all of those things, some of the major things that he said was, we cleaned the landmines laid in the way of Pakistan's interests and doused the fire that erupted because of mismanagement, inefficiency and conspiracy in running the affairs of the country, including economy and foreign affairs. This brief 1.5-year period was a journey from the darkness of hopelessness to the light of hope. It was the beginning of gaining something after losing everything. It was a journey of returning to development from anarchy and chaos. This was the journey of restoring human dignity, chastity, national self-sufficiency, media and freedom of speech. We'll be talking about the media, role of media, freedom of speech, the national self-sufficiency, which the Prime Minister particularly spoke about. Of course, the IMF standby arrangement and its ramifications itself, the Prime Minister's continued emphasis on the fact that this is only a standby arrangement, his continued emphasis on the fact that this is the best that could have been done for Pakistan in the kind of situation that this government came in and the decisions it was forced to take because of the past. We'll be talking about all of this, the fact that they had to sacrifice politics to protect the state. Some of the other important things the Prime Minister said, let's hear.
Humne 4 saal ki बर्बादियों का हत्तुल मकदूर मलबा साफ किया, पाकिस्तान के मफादात की राह में बिछाई गई बारूदी सुरंगें साफ की, माशी तबाही से निकलकर माशी इस्तेहकाम की तरफ लौट आने का सफर था। इस अरसे में हमने सियासत नहीं की, रियासत की हिफाजत की। हमने रियासत बचाने के लिए अपनी सियासत की कुर्बानी दी, वोट बैंक की फिक्र नहीं की। हम
We have with us today Dr. Abid Abbasi, who is a political analyst. Thank you so much for joining us today. We also have with us Iftikhar Ahmad, who is a senior journalist, Rana Maqbool Ahmad, who is a senator with PML-N, and Zulfikar Ali Badar, spokesperson of Chairman BPP, Bilawal, Bhutto, Zardari. Thank you so much for being with us. Gee, Abid Saab, like I said, you know, the fact that one of the particular statements that seems to have resonated is the Prime Minister saying, siyasat and riyasat. The fact that, you know, they sacrificed politics, their own politics, for the country. How do you look at the overall address and its ramifications, the fact that he refuted a lot of conspiracy theories also that were being expounded?
Thank you very much, Mahrukh. I think this is something very, positive for the nation, that according to the constitution, after 1 month or so, the government has to complete its tenure. And then according to the constitution, 18th amendment, there is a prerogative that this is an obligation rather, the caretaker government would take over the country and then it would hold the elections of the country. It is very positive. There were so many conspiracy theories being floated by various quarters that elections won't be holding on the given time, and there would be some sort of ways and means were being discussed that the financial emergency or any political emergency would be imposed in the country to enhance the given tenure of the constitutional tenure of the government. But after the very clear cut and the very straightforward stance of the Prime Minister that he or his government would hand over the reign of power to the caretaker government, at least at this level, that's very much positive stance. Secondly, he is to a great extent right, that after the failure of the previous governments and the mess they have created and the economy that was at the lowest ebb in the last 30 or 40 years of the country, and the policies which they took, the failures of that government, that was a complete complete failure. That government was brought into fashion, let me say this, in an artificial arrangement. That was a selected government, quote unquote, has been saying.
Abid, there's a lot that, you know, I want to go on and talk about that. But there's still a lot that, you know, is not clear in terms of the arrangement between the political parties within the PDM, in terms of, you know, before the next elections, all of those things. I want to come and talk more about that. Let me go to Senator Rana Maqbool Saab. Gee, Senator Saab, can you hear me?
Yes, loud and clear.
Rana Saab, this, you know, like I said, of course, the things that the Prime Minister has said have resonated, because, you know, there is the fact that there was so much criticism, and the PMLN faced that criticism, you know, in an upfront manner. They took the decisions that they thought were best for the country. We are seeing some of the fruits of those decisions. Of course, you know, the Prime Minister remains very categorical, very clear in saying that these are not permanent solutions, but they are solutions nevertheless in the kind of environment that the government walked into. But what about the answers to questions like what kind of a seat alignment we can expect between, for example, your party and the PPP?
Thank you, Mahrukh. Prime Minister is absolutely correct. While appreciating the situation and analyzing it, the previous catastrophic situation, once the sovereign agreement was defied and there was a betrayal of cause of commitment internationally, and that has told heavily on the financial health of the nation. We were also almost close to disaster of default and bankruptcy, but somehow there God has saved us. And this, though not very big help, but it's at this moment, it's very substantive for us, because we have now an opportunity to stand on our feet and we can proceed further, because this token help, I'll call it token help by IMF, means a lot, because the other stakeholders and the monetary institutions, world monetary institutions, they are also coming forward. And they are friendly states who are also helping in a big way. So I think we are on the way to consolidate our economic system and the country in itself. Now you have asked me about the alliance and about the cooperation with the within two main parties, People's Party and the Muslim League N. Today, the president of the largest province of Muslim League, PML-N, he has very clearly explained to the pressmen today afternoon that we are going to make in all constituencies our candidates participate in the elections, may it be National Assembly or may it be the Provincial Assembly. So we are going to give candidates to all the constituencies, and we'll contest elections with full preparation and full vigor.
Right.
And therefore, there's not much of state, much of space left for cooperation. Yes, he also said there'll be a marginal chance of seat adjustment here or there, but in very few numbers. And I personally think there is no intention or plan of PMLN to go for alliances or the seat adjustments in a big way. The Muslim League is going to participate.
That seems to be a good strategy. Let the best man win. I mean, of course, when one looks at that. But Zulfikar Saab, what about you know, the fact that South Punjab has remained, you know, a focal point as far as the gossip about seat adjustment is particularly, you know, we've also seen the former president Asif Ali Zardari Saab take a very avid interest in Punjab. How do you expect this to pan out, in your opinion, you know, as far as every party now agreeing to field their candidates? So like Rana Saab is saying, all the rumors about there being seat adjustment there having been refuted.
Bismillah Rahman Rahim. Thank you very much, Mahrukh, for inviting me to your show. Basically, I have been talking a lot about this, and our party policy is very clear, as stated by the Honorable Senator Saab, and I have been stating this before as well, that Pakistan People's Party is going to contest the election on its own symbol, and we will be fielding our candidates on all our seats, and we will be fighting on ground there will be a collaboration and coordination with the parties who are currently in allies in the government, because this was a brainchild of Mr. Bilawal Bhutto Zardari, that he brought all the political parties, all the stakeholders, all the heads of political parties on one platform, and they all actually have damaged their political, you know, reputation, and they have sacrificed for the sake of Pakistan and for the sake of people of Pakistan, and brought back the diplomatic engagement with the world, and they have revived back on the path of economic development. And very soon you will be hearing that the foreign reserves number is going to be a double digit number. Pakistan People's Party leadership, Mr. Asif Ali Zardari, has been meeting with number of people in South Punjab, in Central Punjab, and Pakistan People's Party have been meeting and interacting with people who are willing to join People's Party from different parties, and we have been looking and checking the background of the people with good reputation and with good education, and their behavior, especially their political behavior. And few of them have actually
joined. Zulfikar Sahab, isn't it a little late for that now?
You see, it's never too late in politics, because People's Party has its own people as well, and well, we also have to accommodate the people who are actually want to be politically groomed and politically fielded in politics. And we have to give opportunity to other people as well. And if people wants to join People's Party, and People's Party have a place, that particular constituency, to accommodate that person, I don't think we have a problem in accommodating that person.
The one other party which we can talk about, that has been in power previously. Do you expect people from there to join? I mean, what is the expectation now as far as the PPP is concerned?
You see, our party is very clear. It's not that everybody is being welcomed in the party. We have to see the political reputation and behavior of the person before allowing that person to join Pakistan People's Party.
You're saying it has to be on merit. But of course you want electable.
Because one person who has been going below the belt and the party is going to give him opportunity, I think that is going to be a damage to political party leadership. Because they have been saying bad things about the party and its leadership, and then we accommodate them in our party. I think there will be a lot of questions from within the party as well. So we are
going to get the opportunity. Let me come back to you. I'll go to Abid Sahab here in the studio. Gee, Abid Sahab, you heard what Zulfikar Sahab said. You've also heard what Rana Sahab is saying. Overall, do you expect there to be more joinings? Do you expect there to be more changes, within the PPP as far as joinings are concerned? Because now, you know, earlier on we spoke about the fact that there might be seat adjustments, but that's not happening, it seems. So it's each party for themselves. Do you think it's going to, perhaps, of course, it'll divide the votes more than perhaps. How do you look at that?
It happens, but everybody, we should keep in mind that Pakistan People's Party is not part of PDM. That is part of the coalition government, but the People's Party was, ousted from the PDM alliance, or People's Party left that alliance, way back. But we have seen that's a very, long history of confrontation between these two political parties. There are the political rivalry of these political parties, and I think all the parties, especially these two big parties, they do not have, particularly in Punjab, the PML-N has not much room to offer anything to People's Party, one thing. Second thing, and similarly, the People's Party won't offer anything to PML-N, for that matter, in Sindh, because they are very much comfortable in the province of Sindh. And after some notables from the south joining Pakistan People's Party while President Asif Ali Zardari's stayed at Lahore, and he met so many people from South and even from the central Punjab. And Pakistan People's Party thinks, what I feel as an impartial analyst, that they are of the view that Bilawal Bhutto Zardari, along with a very few cabinet minister, has shown some performance on the ground during these 1.5 years. He was very much busy outside the country, and he was successful along with other stakeholders to get Pakistan out of FATF. And similarly, he has got some attentions while raising the Pakistan's stance regarding the environmental hazards and environmental destruction in the province of Sindh, and the world was positive. And so he has developed his image while being in China, while being in Europe, while being in other America and other countries of the world. This is the the understanding of Pakistan People's Party's think tanks, that People's Party has gained some popularity, gained some sort of posture, particularly in southern Punjab. And if they wins better seats in Sindh, and most probably in Karachi city as well, because recently they have got the slot of Karachi's mayor. And if they could play some good role in Punjab, what their perception is that they were not allowed to freely contest elections in the elections of 2013 and 2018 in the province of Punjab. And if they are given a level playing field this time in Punjab, they would play better. This is their understanding, their calculation. And on the other hand, they also think that the burden of the economy, the failures of economy, or the price hike that was primarily putting some sort of pressure on PML-N during the coming elections. And secondly, we have seen in 2018 the major parties in Punjab were the PTI or the PMLN. And we should see also, we should wait and see what happens in the constitutional, the area of the country, in the courts. Either the after 9th May, we should not forget that that is an anomaly in the history of Pakistan, that a political party, ruined the state, symbols, or they attacked literally on the state institutions. What happens in the courts of law? Either the PTI as a political party is going to be banned in the country by the state institutions, rather election commissions or the courts, or PTI is facing some more trouble in Punjab. And most probably the major contest between these three political parties, and all would struggle and strive. And I think it's an healthy sign that all political parties should play their role.
Let there be a level playing field and everyone should contest. Of course, Rana sahab, there is, on the one hand, there is, the fact that there should be a level playing field, all the parties should contest. On the other hand, there's also a statement that's come that there, you are not necessarily, your party is not supporting any kind of ban on any particular political party. Your party is sure about your popularity, and you are not, that seems to be a kind of angle or a direction in which you're not supporting that as a party. Isn't that true?
Yes, both the main parties, they are on one wavelength as far as this situation is concerned. They are not in favor of banning the party. They have been very strongly demanding that the all guilty who have done such a ghastly crime vis-a-vis the symbols, the sacred symbols of nation and the defense forces, they should be taken to task and they should be punished. The people who are innocent, they should not be touched even with a long pole. That is the basic demand of both the parties, all the parties. But at the same time, the political activity should be allowed to carry on, and the party as a party may not be banned. The people who are responsible for this heinous crime, and they should be punished. That is the demand of all the political parties. So therefore, there is no pressure as far as political parties are concerned to ban this party. There is the only demand to take stringent action against the people who are responsible.
But including what about the popularity the as far as the party itself is concerned? Zulfikar Saab, one can, you know, disagree with their politics. One can disagree with the politics of the former Prime Minister, 9th May and what happened. But do you think that, you know, in terms of the vote bank, how confident are you, you know, because we saw until recently the former Prime Minister making statements like, you know, it doesn't matter who he chooses to contest on his ticket, but he seemed confident of his appeal, his vote bank. How do you respond to that? How does the PPP see things?
See, in my personal anticipation, I personally feel that there is a damage to PPI because of the 9th May incident. And if the chairman PTI is confident, I mean, absolutely he has the right to be, to live in a utopia, because whatever he has done in his tenure, he has actually given an irreparable loss and damage to the country and the people of Pakistan. So if he's still in utopia and he's not coming out to see actually at the grassroots level that the people have changed their minds, and it is going to be a challenging election. It is going to be a contest between the three parties. But still, the kind of support he used to have, it's still not there. Because there are not only one factor, there are a number of factors which actually varies and matters in the election, especially for winning the election. So in my personal opinion, I feel that PTI vote bank not still the same, and it's changed, and it will take time to. I don't think that the situation is going to be ever going to be same what they used, the kind of support they used to have before.
I think there's a problem with your audio. I'll come back to you. I'm going to go to Rana Saab before I go to Abid Saab. Rana Saab, what about you know, reports of there being, as far as the coalition itself is concerned, there being issues within the coalition? How accurate are they? Because of course it's going to be a rather lengthy, tedious process as far as choosing the caretaker governments, all of those things, and there needs to be an agreement on those major issues also. So how, you know, there are yet, we've seen, I mean, there were certain reports as far as, you know, in the UAE also, there were disagreements between your party within the PDM. How does, how would you respond to that?
Allow me to explain a little
position
of the vote bank. There are latest developments, and I personally think people are very strongly reacting to it. The serious demand by Israeli state and demonstrating so much of sympathy and sincerity with the PTI leadership, that is really very counterproductive. And people never like Israel being an atrocious state who have been killing Muslim right, left and center. This factor will also be there in the election campaign, and this factor cannot be overlooked by the masses and the voters. Now, as far as the disagreement, as you have mentioned, there is not disagreement at all. For example, the meeting between, informal meeting between two leaders in Dubai doesn't mean that they have reached some final conclusion about the decision regarding the caretakers, etc. Had there been some serious negotiations and some conclusive parleys, there had to be some announcement or press release by the leadership. It was not there. It's therefore, Mr. Fazlur Rahman, who objected to it, he has been very clearly and convincingly told that there is nothing of the sort. All of the PDM, all the allies will sit together, discuss all the issues one by one, and then we'll reach a consensus to take decisions about the caretakers as well as other issues regarding the elections. So there is no systematic situation as far as the arrangement or the policy in the election by the political parties and political alliances concerned.
Right, fair enough. Let me come back to you. Abid Saab, do you think, you know, of course there have, from time to time, it's healthy, of course, when there are so many parties which are part of the PDM. And we've seen there being disagreements, but by and large, of course, you know, the 1.5 year that the PDM has been in governance, there has been agreement on all broad policies. How do you see now, you know, the next chapter as far as the caretaker setup is concerned? The decisions have to be, you know, in coordination, in agreement between all the parties within the PDM.
I don't think so that there would be some, you know, very mighty kind of difference between them. They're mature politicians and they know the situation of the country where we are, sir. We are passing through a very crucial phase of our history. That's it. We have been saying, listening this cliche for the last 75 years, that this is the defining movement of our country. But this time, I think it is really a very crucial and a very defining movement of this country. So the mature politicians like Mia Nawaz Sharif or Shahbaz Sharif or Asif Ali Zardari and Maulana Fazlur Rahman, they know well the situation, they gauge very well the situation, and I think the state institutions are also very much, you know, understanding the grave situation of the country. We just, for the sake of, you know, a very small amount, the country's economy remain in the standstill condition. Some of the mistakes have been made by the government. For instance, we should not go there very much into the past, but before 10 months, the demands which were being surfaced by the IMF, those should have been accepted if they are accepted now. But even then, the situation is not very much, you know, satisfactory in terms of economy and in terms of politics. So these mature politicians would take very serious and very mature steps ahead. What I feel that,
but do you expect from the electorate? Of course, you know, on the one hand, we have, you know, we have to take mature decisions. We have to take decisions, and again, the Prime Minister also said that we've sacrificed politics for the state. Do you think that the electorate will see it that way?
Of course, there are, you know, the various segments of society, various you know, categories of the people in this. Some people do get inspired by the mere sort of, you know, emotional slogans like the previous government and the former prime minister have been raising, taking, you know, multiple U-turns time and again. He was saying that it was an international conspiracy, was taking the name of United States, and, you know, very vehemently in the public jalsas he was criticizing them, and later on we have seen that he was begging some support from the US parliamentarians to get some sort of, you know, the relief for him. And similarly, the Rana Sahab has very rightly said that Pakistani, the people of Pakistan, either they are educated people or either they are lesser educated people, they are very much sensitive about Kashmir and Israel, the Palestinian, the miseries meted by the people of Palestine in the hands of the Israel, and that support at a very, you know, highest level, that would also play a very significant role. And now the things are folding one after another. In 2018, there was a charisma of the former prime minister, and we should not forget that the whole state institutions, the even judiciary, even some of the segments of establishment, and they were forcing the media to give, you know, long-lasting, long hours of coverage to that political party, and the social media was used, and so many other tactics were used to bring that government into fashion. But, you know, fortunately or unfortunately, that government failed drastically, or the hopes of those powerful quarters of the people, they are very much, you know, clear that this government and these people, they were more, you know, like jugglers, like, you know, sort of making tall claims, and they, you know, damage the state interest or the economy, the politics, the freedom of speech, and everything, even foreign, you know, there are some, not a single voice has come from the whole Muslim world for the so-called quote-unquote Muslim leader of the Muslim world. There was not a single voice for him, but the voices coming from the Israel and those, you know, sort of areas which are not acceptable, not for the state of Pakistan, not for the people of Pakistan, anybody in Pakistan, even in the Muslim world. So that's a very notorious kind of, you know, incidents have been taking place in Israel against the Muslims. How people of Pakistan would accept that? And these are, you know, raising some serious questions, because we have seen in past, if we should not forget that the speech of Dr. Israrulak and even the very notable gentleman from Karachi, Hakim Saeed, and many other people have been raising that there are some support from the foreign countries to this political party. And that has, I don't do not blame anything without having a proof, but we have seen some sort of, you know, atmosphere, some sort of hunch coming from that, because why the voices are coming from those countries, not from the Muslim countries, not from any friendly country of Pakistan, but the countries which are, you know, by and large considered the enemy.
But you see the former Prime Minister himself contesting the elections.
If he is not, you know, disqualified by the constitutional institution of the state, the government, the most probably he would fight the elections. And if there is no case against him, such he is not, you know, declared illegal his contesting elections, unless he should contest elections. Everybody has the right to contest elections, but I don't think so. There are very serious cases against him. According to the law expert, there are some open and shut cases against him.
But we haven't
the foreign
seen
funding case, you know, there are some very, you know, sort of objectionable.
Let me go to Rana sir, but we've seen the cases continuing. We've also, but we haven't seen any judgment come in the field
so far. But there is a much time, you know, prior to the elections. We have three, four months to get into the election mode.
Right, Rana sir, do you expect there to be, you know, the former Prime Minister to contest the next elections, his party to be in the field? What do you expect?
Yes, if there is a declaration by any court against him, and he turns out to be a convict in any case, then he'll not be competent to eligible to contest the elections. And once he is convicted in any case, he stands disqualified to contest the election. So there are ample chances, as we already discussed in the last two interactions with you, the level of overwhelming evidence is so irrefutable and invincible. Once the case starts, it will be finishing within 10, 15 days, and the result will be there, and nobody can contradict and refute that evidence. May it be forensic, etc., or graphic, or circumstantial, the evidence of conspiracy and abetment, and evidence of any nature, all pieces of evidence and with their full strength are there against him. So it will be very difficult for any court to absolve him or to acquit him. That is the situation, frankly speaking. Because the crime which has... Sorry.
Right, fair enough. Zulfikar sir, what kind of a scenario does the PPP expect, you know, pursuant to, of course, after the caretaker set up in the next elections, as far as the popular appeal is concerned, as far as your inroads again into Punjab is concerned, and you know, of course, Karachi and Sindh remains your forte?
I personally feel Pakistan People's Party is going to go into the fight fully on the grassroots level. Pakistan People's Party is going to get in Karachi and in Hyderabad, because the you know what kind of taken place. Pakistan People's Party in the last local bodies at the mayor.
There's a problem with audio. Let me. Ji, Abid sir, the PPP has, you know, of course we've seen, and I think Zulfikar sir was also talking towards about the fact that, you know, we saw what happened as far as the elections in Karachi is concerned, as far as, of course, Sindh remains the hold. But again, Asif Ali Zardari sahab and, you know, the PPP has been trying to recoup their hold as far as Punjab also is concerned. Do you expect there to be perhaps a division between the upper Punjab and the lower, you know, the southern Punjab?
There are some pockets even in central Punjab where PPP could play a better role. We should keep in consideration that in 2013, People's Party did not launch even its campaign in the whole province of Punjab. We haven't seen the central leadership of Pakistan People's Party. At that time, there was not, you know, the one, central leader of the party, because Asif Ali Zardari sir was in presidency and Bilawal Bhutto was not at much active. You know, he was too younger at that time for that, sort of campaign to launch in Punjab. And some of the, brands of Pakistan People's Party, they do claim that they were not allowed. But we should, remember that the banned organization, the TTP, that has threatened Pakistan People's Party or MKOM and Awami National Party to take part into the election, the situation was very much grave for them, for all the secular or the progressive political parties of the country. Similarly, in 2018 elections, the situation was not very much favorable for Pakistan People's Party, and they did not, heartedly, launch a campaign in Punjab. And now we should keep in mind, being a political science student, that Bilawal Bhutto Zardari has emerged as a mighty leader of the party. Either, he has charisma which the other leaders of the country has, that has or not, that is but he is emerged as a towering leader of the country, and he has shown some tremendous capabilities internationally, and even at the national level, some of very mature. If we go through his speeches in the National Assembly, if we talk about his stance on various issues, human rights issues, the media's freedom issues, and the other marginalized segments of society, his stance that is appreciated by the progressive people of the country. So after having this sort of mess which was created by PTI in previous elections, and while being in the power, and the way the fascist style, the fascist tendencies they have used for their political motives to achieve, I think the people of Punjab, as in either. And one more thing I would say, being a student of Pakistani politics, that People's Party, when joined hand with the PML-N in the Charter of Democracy, and later on in 2013 when President Zardari remained very much quiet while being launching any campaign in Punjab, the common jala of Pakistan People's Party was not happy, and they have joined Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf at that time in retaliation, in reaction that Pakistan People's Party has given a free hand to PML-N in Punjab, because they have been political rivals, stark political rivals for a long period of time.
Like Zulfikar Saab also said, and we've seen a lot of joinings happen as far as in the South are concerned. Do you think a lot of people will perhaps return, or
some of the people have returned? We have seen some people who were previously very, sort of long affiliation with Pakistan People's Party. They left party for, they were there. I would say that if a very high level people, the people sitting at a very high echelon power, if they were misguided by the previous former prime minister and his tall slogans and hakiki azadi and and revolution and tsunami and change and blah blah blah, the people of Pakistan People's Party, a lot of, they were also misguided, they were also went into that fantasy, but now they are mature enough to see that, to come back to their own mother political
Rana Saab, the Prime Minister has said that this may have, they have taken difficult decisions at the cost of their political capital, but this is certainly, Pakistan is not out of the woods yet. We've also seen, as far as the country is concerned, whichever government next comes in has to continue on the same lines, has to steer the country out of the quagmire as far as our economy is concerned, as far as our general, we've seen the situation as far as, our law and justice reform is due for a long time, economic reforms are due. There is, across the board agreement that major changes will have to be made and continued during, after whichever the next government is. It's not going to be an easy task. In that kind of a scenario, like you have always said, that Mia Nawaz Sharif will return very soon. Do you expect there to be changes? We saw Mariam Nawaz also saying that it has to be very performance-based as far as awarding of tickets is concerned, as far as, as far as the phenomena of electables are concerned. In the elections, do you expect landmark decisions?
Yes, there's no doubt about it. This is a massive challenge. It's a colossal challenge. And the situation is very tricky and ticklish and complex. But all the same, once Mia Nawaz Sharif returns to Pakistan, he has a history and a past record. And people do have very profound association with him, his voters in particularly, and people at large. His record is there, starting from defense impregnability in case of Pakistan making a nickel state and in a way impregnable state, and then going to the field of economy, the social development and development as network of motorways, and bringing the CPAC and establishing lot many industrial concerns, and going for in a way fulfillment of the energy sector needs. And these are all issues and achievements to his credit, to Myanmar's credit. Once he lands in Pakistan, it will be a breath of fresh air for the voters and for the country. And once he tells anything to the masses, it will make a sea change in the minds and the hearts of the people. And we are sure, inshallah, about his credentials, and he'll prove the same as he already did. Despite odds and despite lot many difficulties, he has been overcoming all the difficulties and making a Pakistan a prosperous and a developed state. Like once he left in 2017, you might remember the level of GDP and the jobs and the energy level and the energy reforms in other sectors, law reforms and clinching terrorism in the country. A multi-dimensional effort which he made and endeavor that those brought fruit. And once he restarts with the same mission on the same lines, it will bring a lot of change, a positive change in the country. And I personally think the things will altogether change within months, inshallah. So therefore, there's a lot of hope as far as we are concerned. And I'm sure
is the PML-N committed to reform?
Oh yes, reforms of all types, including judicial, industrial, agriculture, energy sector, even in minerals and all sectors. And first of all, they are going to focus on which couldn't be done due to certain inadequacies, and then doing away the dead units, the dormant units, which are a liability. So there will be massive privatization, which will bring a lot of funds, and it will also decrease the financial liability on the public sector. So all these reforms will be launched simultaneously. And God willing, he has already made a plan how to change the fate of nation as far as the economy is concerned, industrial sector is concerned, agriculture sector is concerned. And I think it will be a gateway to prosperity and self-sufficiency.
Fair enough. On that note, Zulfikar Saab, my last question to you. You know, broadly we've seen, like Abid Saab here also said, that, you know, we saw Bilawal Bhutto Zardari's leadership perhaps, you know, more clear in the last year or so. We've seen him take the reins of the party like never before. There has been, of course, there is the former president Asif Ali Zardari, but the leadership of Bilawal Bhutto Zardari himself. Do you expect there to be major changes before the elections?
I foresee that when Mr. Bilawal Bhutto Zardari is going to lead the campaign in the public gatherings, I think that will make a difference. That difference is going to bring people on board with the Pakistan People's Party. That will increase the voters of Pakistan People's Party. That will bring back the people who have been dormant and who have left People's Party. They are going to turn back to People's Party and vote for that hope that Mr. Bilawal Bhutto Zardari is going to bring on board in his political philosophy and political manifesto. And not that Mr. Bilawal Bhutto Zardari, his sister is going to support him, assist him, and she will be leading the campaign as well alongside with him. So I think the duo of these two young leaders is going to bring about a change in the youngsters and the future generations of Pakistan, which will turn the voters of Pakistan People's Party for now, for this election, coming election, and for coming elections as well. So this is going to be a very challenging, interesting, and futuristic task to bring people on board. And this will give rise to the people who are actually wanting to...
All the time that we have. Thank you so much for being with us, Dr. Abid Abbasi. Thank you for joining us. Rana Maqbool Ahmad Saab, thank you for being with us. Zulfikar Ali Badar Saab, thank you for joining us today. Of course, we saw the Prime Minister set the right tone. We saw him being upfront as to what has been achieved in the last nearly 1.5 years and what remains, what is a long road of what needs to be achieved for Pakistan as a country. That kind of candidness, that kind of out-of-the-box ownership of what the decisions that have been taken are perhaps unprecedented. And we of course will know more as far as the next elections are concerned. The kind of seat adjustments now that, you know, of course it's been refuted that all parties will be contesting in on all constituencies. And it'll be a level playing field to see who it is that will win and what kind of a scenario and what kind of a setup will emerge. Thank you so much for joining us today on Buzz.